Former England captain Andrew Flintoff retired from all forms of cricket effective Thursday 16th September, admitting defeat after a long battle against a serious knee injury. The 32-year-old Lancashire all-rounder, who won 79 test caps and became a national icon by playing a leading role in England winning back the Ashes in 2005, made his decision after speaking to a surgeon in Glasgow on Wednesday. Having been told that my body would no longer stand up to the rigors of cricket, I had no alternative but to retire, Flintoff said. His last match was a test against Australia at the Oval in August 2009, when England won to regain the Ashes. In an 11-year test career, he had 226 wickets at 32.78 and hit 3,845 runs with an average of 31.77. Any attempt by Liverpool's co-owner Tom Hicks to gain sole control of the club will have no support from the majority of Liverpool's board, but could succeed, BBC Sport understands. Texan billionaire Hicks met Liverpool chairman Martin Broughton on Wednesday, informing him he was considering raising money to refinance the club's £237.4 million debt with Royal Bank of Scotland before a deadline set for early October. The talks were described by a senior club source as blunt but constructive, but the prospect of Hicks remaining in control of the Premier League club will horrify many Liverpool fans desperate for a change of ownership. Co-owner George Gillette is reported to be struggling to pay back £75 million loan secured against his 50% stake in the club in 2008, and Hicks is considering buying his partner out, although Gillette insists he is not on the brink of defaulting. Hicks and Gillette bought the Reds in February 2007 in a deal that valued the club at £218.9 million. Rafael Nadal was quick to play down talk of him overtaking Roger Federer's record haul of 16 Grand Slams after winning his first U.S. Open title. The Spaniard, 24, beat Novak Djokovic 6-4, 5-7, 6-4, 6-2 in New York to earn his ninth Grand Slam crown and complete his second set of winning all four major titles. Asked about Federer's tally of 16 slams, he said, "It's very far. For me, it's too far to think about that. I think talk about if I'm better or worse than Roger is stupid." Nadal joins Federer, Andre Agassi, Roy Emerson, Rod Laver, Don Budge, and Fred Perry in having won all four Grand Slams, and also becomes the first man since Laver swept the board in 1969 to win the French Open, Wimbledon, and US Open in the same year. And at 5 years younger than Federer, the Majorcan has time on his side in the pursuit of more major victories. This has been another edition of your IKTV News Update. I'm Lafern Fraser. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again starting at 7 p.m. But first, here's your IKTV quote of the day.